Hello friends, welcome to my Civil Engineering MCQ channel. In this video, we will discuss about most important multiple choice questions with detailed explanation in design of steel structure. This video helpful for PWD, WRD, RRB, JEE, MIDC, ZP exams and it is also helpful for various competitive exams. So let's start. Question number first. As per LS specification, what should be the limit on angle of inclination theta of the lacing bar with the longitudinal axis of the component member? It is the first statement. This question is asked to exam WCD 2019. Correct option C, in between 40 degree to 70 degree. Question number first, answer is C. Design specification of lacing. First one, the effective slenderness ratio of laced column should be increased by 5% to account for shear deformation due to unbalanced horizontal forces. Second one, angle of inclination theta of lacing with longitudinal axis should be between 40 and 70 degrees Celsius. Third one, effective slenderness ratio of lacing bar should not exceed 145. Effective length of lacing member LE, त्यामध्ये आहे 3, त्यामध्ये फर्स्ट वन आहे फॉर सिंगल लेसिंग बोल्डेड एल इक्वल टू एल, सेकंड वन फॉर डबल लेसिंग बोल्डेड एल इक्वल टू 0.7L एंड द लास्ट वन फॉर वेल्डेड लेसिंग एल इक्वल टू 0.7L. सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन सी. क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, द इफेक्टिव लेंथ फॉर बॅटन कॉम्प्रेशन मेंबर इन द डिझाईन ऑफ कॉम्प्रेशन मेंबर शुड बी इन्क्रीज्ड बाय परसेंट. राईट ऑप्शन ए 10. नंबर टू, आन्सर इज ए. द इफेक्टिव लेंथ ऑफ बॅटन कॉलम शुड बी इन्क्रीज्ड बाय 10%. क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री, द मॅक्सिमम स्पेसिंग ऑफ लेसिंग बार शुड बी सच दॅट मिनिमम स्लेंडरनेस रेशो ऑफ द कंपोनंट मेंबर इज नॉट ग्रेटर दॅन. राईट ऑप्शन सी 50 ऑर 0.7 इंटू स्लेंडरनेस रेशो ऑफ द मेंबर ॲज अ होल. फॉर बोल्डेड ऑर वेल्डेड लेसिंग सिस्टीम मिनिमम स्लेंडरनेस रेशियो ऑफ कंपोनंट मेंबर इज नॉट ग्रेटर दॅन 50 ऑर 0.7 इंटू स्लेंडरनेस रेशियो ऑफ द मेंबर ॲज अ होल. सो राईट आन्सर ऑप्शन सी.
क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर, वॉट शॅल बी द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ इम्पॅक्ट अलाउन्सेस ऑफ व्हर्टिकल लोड्स इन द केस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक ऑपरेटेड क्रेन्स इन द डिझाईन ऑफ जेंट्री गर्डर ॲज पर द गाईडलाईन्स ऑफ लिमिट स्टेट? करेक्ट आन्सर ऑप्शन सी 25% ऑफ मॅक्सिमम स्टॅटिक व्हील लोड्स.
Number 4, answer is C. Additional load for structure subjected to impact. There are three types of loads. First one, vertical load transferred to the rails. Second one, horizontal loads transferred to the rails. And third one, longitudinal loads along the rails. These kinds of vertical load transferred to the rails. First one, for electric overhead cranes, 25% of maximum static wheel load. Second one, for hand operated cranes, 10% of maximum static wheel load. These kinds of horizontal load transferred to the rails. First one, for electric overhead cranes, 10% of weight of crab and weight of lifted on the crane. Second one, hand operated cranes, 5% of weight of crab and weight of lifted on the crane. Third one, longitudinal loads along the rails, 5% of static wheel loads. So correct option C. Question number 5th, the factor of safety for all loads except wind loads in the design of high strength friction grip bolts is taken as? Right answer option B 1.4.
Question number 6, the overlap of plates to be fillet welded in a lap joint should not be? Right answer option A less than 5 times thickness of thinner part. Question number 7, transverse spacing between longitudinal fillet weld should not be? Right answer option A more than 32T or 300 mm, whichever is lesser.
7, answer A, transverse spacing between longitudinal fillet weld should not be more than 32T or 300 mm, whichever is lesser. The transverse spacing of longitudinal fillet welds used in end condition shall not exceed 18-200 mm unless end transverse welds or intermediate plugs. So correct option A. Question number 8, value of effective throat thickness in case of complete penetration of the butt weld is?
Correct option A, thickness of thinner member jointed. Butt weld or effective throat thickness TE. First one, for partially penetrated butt welds in case of single V, single U, single bevel butt joint, TE equal to 5/8 thickness of thinner member. Second one, for fully penetrated butt welds in case of double V, double U, double bevel butt joint, TE equal to thickness of thinner member. So right answer option A. Question number 9. As per IS code 800/2007, the maximum width of the covered building section should preferably be restricted to beyond which suitable provision for the expansion joint may be made. Here is the right option B, 150 meter. Question number 10. When bars of two different diameter are to be spliced, then which one of the following diameter should be considered for the calculation of value of lap length? Here is the right option A, diameter of smaller bar. Diameter of bar should be considered for the calculation of value of lap length. Correct option A. Question number 11. In the design of beam for torsion, the spacing the stirrups placed perpendicular to the axis of the member shall not exceed mm. First one x1, second one x1 plus y1 upon 4, and third one 300. So right answer option D, minimum of first, second and third. Question number 11, answer is D. Spacing of the stirrups in torsion, first one x1, second one x1 plus y1 upon 4, third one 300, whichever is minimum. Correct option D. Question number 12. Maximum size of fillet weld in the case of weld applied to the round toe of steel section is equal to. Right option A, 3/4 of the thickness of the section at the toe. Maximum size of fillet weld, S max. First one, for square edges, S max equal to thickness of thinner member minus 1.5 mm. Second one, for rounded toe of rolled section, S max equal to 3/4 of the thickness of the section at the toe. Right answer option A. Question number 13. What is the maximum value of clear spacing of intermediate fillet weld in the case of compression member? Here is the right option A, 12T, but in no case B, more than 200 mm. Number 13, answer is A, intermediate fillet weld. When length of fillet weld required transmitting a force less than continuous of fillet weld, clear spacing between intermediate fillet weld should not more than 12T or 200 mm, whichever is less for compression member, and 16T or 200 mm, whichever is less for tension member. So correct answer option A. Question number 14. If the permissible value of stress in tension on a section through throat of butt weld done in shop is 150 Newton per mm square, then the permissible stress in tension on same section when the same welding is done in the field is Newton per mm square. So here is the right option is B, 120. Question number 14, answer is B. Permissible stress in the fillet weld is 20% less than shop weld. Use this formula, sigma filled equal to 0.8 into sigma shop. To keep this value, 0.8 into 150 equal to 120 Newton per mm square. So right answer option B. Question number 15. In the design of steel structure as per limit state method, the value of partial safety factor for resistance governed by ultimate stress is. Here is the correct answer option B, 1.25. Number 50, answer is B, definition partial safety factor. First one, resistance governed by yielding gamma m0 equal to 1.10. Second one, resistance of member to buckling gamma m0 equal to 1.10. Third one, resistance governed by ultimate stress gamma m1 equal to 1.25. So correct option B. Number 15, answer is B, resistance of connection gamma m1. The bolts used in structural steel joint shall be preferred shop fabrication and field fabrication. First one, friction type of bolts gamma m f equal to shop fabrication equal to 1.25 and field fabrication equal to 1.25. Second one, bearing type gamma MB bolts, shop fabrication equal to 1.25 and field fabrication equal to 1.25. Third one, rivet shop fabrication 1.25 and field fabrication 1.25. Weld gamma MW equal to 1.25 for shop fabrication and 1.25 for field fabrication. So answer is B. Question number 16. A steel wire of 40 mm diameter is bent into a circular shape of 20 meter radius if the modulus of elasticity 3 into 10 raised per centimeter square, then maximum stress induced in the wire is. This question is asked to exam PWD 2019. So correct option C, 3 into 10 raised to 3 kg per centimeter square. Question number 60, answer is C, Young's modulus. Use this formula, Young's modulus equal to stress upon strain and cross multiply to it, stress equal to E into strain. So keep these values, 3 into 10 raised to 6 into 40 into 10 raised to minus 3 upon 40. So your answer is come, 3 into 10 raised to 3 kg per centimeter square. So right answer option C. Question number 17. In the design of compression member, if single lacing system is adopted, then thickness T of lacing plate shall not be less than of the length between the inner end rivets or welds. Right answer option B, 1/40. Question number 17, answer is B. Minimum thickness of lacing bar, first one, T minimum greater than or equal to L/40 for single lacing, and second one, T minimum greater than or equal to L/60 for a double lacing, where L equal to length of spacing bar. So right answer option B. Question number 18. The limiting value of slenderness ratio for tension member of structural steel in which reversal of direct stresses may occur is. Correct option A, 180. Question number 18, answer is A, condition for load reversal. Limiting or maximum slenderness ratio, first one, a tension member in which reversal of direct stresses due to other than wind seismic loading, 180. Second one, a member normally acting a tie in roof stresses or bracing system but subjected to possible of reversal of stresses resulting from action of wind or earthquake forces, 350. Third one, for any other tension member other than pre-tensioned member, 400. Right answer option A. Question number 90. The value of partial safety factor as the limit state method for field welded connection is taken as. Here is the right answer option B, 1.25. Question number 90, answer is B, definition, partial safety factor. First one, resistance governed by yielding gamma M0 equal to 1.10. Second one, resistance of member to buckling gamma M0 equal to 1.10. Third one, resistance governed by ultimate stress gamma M1 equal to 1.25. So right answer option B. Resistance of connection gamma M1, shop fabrication and field fabrication. Bolts, friction type gamma MF, shop fabrication 1.25, field fabrication 1.25. Second one, bolts, bearing type gamma MB equal to shop fabrication 1.25 and field fabrication 1.25. Third one, rivet gamma MR, shop fabrication 1.25 and field fabrication 1.25. Last one, weld gamma MW, shop fabrication 1.25 and field fabrication 1.25. Question number 20. When we use HYSD bar instead of mild steel bars, the value of bond strength. Right option C, increases. Question number 20, answer is C. When we used HYSD bar instead of mild steel bars, the value of bond strength increases. Question number 21. The limit of proportionality of a certain steel sample is 600 MPa in simple tension. It is subjected to principal stress of 300 MPa tensile, 60 MPa tensile and 30 MPa tensile. According to the maximum principal stress theory, factor of safety in the case would be. Right option D, 2. Question number 21. Answer is D.
This problem, all values are, only one values are unknown. Find out factor of safety. Given data, sigma y equal to 600 MPa, sigma 1 equal to 300 MPa, sigma 2 equal to 60 MPa, sigma 3 equal to 30 MPa. According to a maximum principal stress theory factor of safety, use this formula. So, sigma y upon sigma 1, to keep this value 600 upon 300, your values come to right answer D.
Question number 22. If the value of effective depth of balanced section of beam is 300 mm, then what will be the limiting value of neutral axis given that grade of steel used in beam is Fe415? Correct option D, 144 mm.
Question number 22. Answer is D. For Fe415, use this formula Xu equal to 0.48D. So, to keep this value 0.48 into 300, cross multiply do it, Xu equal to 144 mm. Right option D.
Question number 23. Which one of the following is the recommended value of partial material safety factor for steel in limit state design method? Right option A, 1.15.
Question number 23. Answer is A. In limit state design method, material and partial safety factor for steel equal to 1.15 partial safety factor and second one concrete partial safety factor 1.5 for concrete. Question number 24. Which one of the following limit states are covered under limit state of serviceability? Right option D, both deflection and cracking.
Question number 24. Answer is D. There are limit states are covered under limit state of serviceability. First one deflection, second one cracking, third one durability, fourth one overall stability, fifth one fire resistance and sixth one excessive vibration. There are under limit state of serviceability.
Question number 25. The limit of proportionality of a certain steel sample is 500 MPa in simple tension. It is subjected to principal stresses of 125 MPa tensile, 80 MPa tensile and 60 MPa tensile. According to the maximum principal stresses theory, factor of safety in this case would be the right option A, 4. Question number 25. Answer is A. Given data, Fy equal to 500 MPa, sigma 1 equal to 125 MPa, sigma 2 equal to 80 MPa, sigma 3 equal to 80 MPa. According to a maximum principal stress theory, sigma 1 less than or equal to sigma y, factor of safety, find out, use this formula to keep these values, sigma y upon sigma 1, 500 upon 125 equal to 4. So, right option A. Question number 26. A steel wire of 20 mm diameter is bent into a circular shape of 10 meter radius. If maximum stress induced in the wire is 4 into 10 raised to 3 kg per centimeter square, then what will be the modulus of elasticity? This question is asked to exam PWD 2019. Right option C, 4 into 10 raised to 6 kg per centimeter square. Question number 26. Answer is C. In this formula, modulus of elasticity equal to stress upon strain. So keep these values 4 into 10 raised to 3 upon 20 into 10 raised to minus 3 upon 20. So 4 into 10 raised to 6 kg per centimeter square is the right answer. Option C is the correct answer. Question number 27. In design of steel structure as per limit state method, the value of partial safety factor for resistance to buckling is correct option A, 1.1. Question number 27. Answer is A. Definition and partial safety factor. First one, resistance governed by yielding gamma m0 equal to 1.10. Second one, resistance of member to buckling gamma m0 equal to 1.10. Third one, resistance governed by ultimate stress gamma m1 equal to 1.25. Resistance of connection gamma m1 and shop fabrication and field fabrication. First one, bolts friction type gamma mf. Shop fabrication 1.25 and 1.25 for field fabrication. Second one, bolts bearing type gamma mb. shop fabrication 1.25, and field fabrication 1.25. Third one, rebate gamma MR 1.25 for shop fabrication and 1.25 for field fabrication. Fourth one, weld gamma MW 1.25 for shop fabrication and 1.25 for field fabrication. Right answer option A. Question number 28. If the value of effective depth of balanced section of beam is 400 mm, then what will be the limiting value of neutral axis given that grade of steel used in beam is Fe415? This is also question is PWD 2019. Right option D, 192 mm. Question number 28, answer is D. For Fe415, use this formula XU max 0.48D. So keep this value 0.48D equal to 400. So right answer 192 mm. Correct option D. Question number 29, while designing the structural member for limit state of collapse in shear, characteristic strength of stirrup shall not be greater than. Right option B, 415 Newton per mm square. Question number 29, answer is B, characteristic strength of stirrup shall not be greater than 415 Newton per mm square. Right option B. Question number 30, minimum pitch distance between centers of holes, rivet holes is not less than dash time the hole diameter. This question is asked to exam Aurangabad MNC 2019. Correct option B, 2.5 times. Question number 30, answer is B, minimum pitch, P minimum equal to 2.5 multiply nominal diameter of rivet or shank diameter of rivet, maximum pitch, first one for tension member, P max equal to 16T or 200 mm whichever is less, second one for compression member, P max equal to 12T or 200 mm whichever is less. Right option B. Question number 31. The value of partial safety factor for steel is? This question is asked to exam BMC 2019. Right option B, 1.15. Question number 31. Answer is B. In limit state design method, material and partial safety factor. First one, steel equal to 1.15 partial safety factor. And the second one, concrete equal to 1.5 partial safety factor. Here this video is finished. I hope this video will be helpful for your exams. For more updates, subscribe to my channel and don't forget to share this video with your friends. Thank you so much.